Hello, welcome to apenasimagens.com channel. My name is Wagner Lungoff, and in this video I'm going to show you a homemade large format camera bag. It was based on this Linhof camera. This is a 18 by 13 centimeters Super Technica, but it has a reduction back to 4 by 5 inches or 9 by 12 centimeters. And this is exactly the part that I built, and I'm going to show you the outcome. It might be interesting for you if you have in mind building your own large format camera. For those not yet familiar with large format cameras, they work like this. You have the lens, it sends the image to a ground glass. It's over here, the actual image, it's over here that the photographer will make composition, focusing, perspective correction, whatever. And once he's happy with the result, he has to lock the tripod, close the lens, insert the film holder, and by pulling the dark slide, the camera is ready for shooting. For a homemade project, I think it would be very difficult to build the holders themselves. It's far easier to work with what is available in the market, and there are thousands of those out there. You can easily find some in auction websites. Just pay attention to the aspect of sizes, because we have the metric system that is 9 by 12 centimeters and the imperial system that is 4 by 5 inches. Externally, they are the same. That means if the camera bag accepts one of them, it will accept the other one as well. But at the time of purchasing film, you have to buy the correct one. You can see here that the 4 by 5 inches is a bit larger than the 9 by 12 centimeters. So it's better to do a quick research and check beforehand what is readily available for your country. In my case, I decided to build a camera bag for this camera. This is a Thornton Picard. It was built probably around 1900, and it came with a ground glass, but it was an odd size. It was something in between a quarter plate and half plate, and no film holders at all. So I decided to build a new bag that would allow me to use standard film holders with contemporary film. And this is the outcome. The overall finish, of course, it's far worse than the camera itself. But it works. It's a bit ugly, but it works. I can easily load film. I have to lift this part here, and it goes like a drawer. It's locked inside very firmly. I can operate the dark slide easily to put in and out. One feature that's about the camera, but I think you should consider if you're going for a large format camera project, is the ability of switching between portrait and landscape. I think it was nicely solved in this camera, and I built the camera back in order to keep that feature. Otherwise, I tested it already, it has no light leaks, and it's working. Details about this project, like the measurements, materials, and step-by-step, I found more convenient to put all of that in a written form, so you can find it in my website, apenasimagens.com. In case you came here directly to YouTube, you can find the link in the description of this video. And also in the website, you can find a tutorial for making the ground glass, and that would complete the camera bag. Well, I hope you liked it, and I hope you got inspired to make your large format camera, and see you next time.